Barney.
Yes. Exactly.
Oh man.
But no French religious stuff. She lives nearby. She lives by the screen. But she like breaks her ankle yesterday. Of course. So, and she lives by herself, so it's another chicken.
Today is for the Palestinian women and the Israeli women. Today is for the descendants of slaves. Today is for the colonized women. Today is for the lesbian women. Today is for the queer women. Today is for the bi women. Today is for the women who don't give a fudge about gender conformity. Today is for the trans women, for the poor women, for the fat women. Today is for the immigrants and the refugees and the migrant women. Today is for the girls who will become women, the victims of human trafficking women, the women who believe in gods that you do not know women. Today is for the developmentally delayed and the mentally ill women. Today is for the incarcerated women. Women and their families. Today is for the chronically ill women, tired of Western medicine, who can't or cannot make it to the rally. Today is for the HIV positive women. Today is for the women fighting cancer. Today is for the women who live without health insurance. Today is for the infertile women who pray that their bodies will work women. Today is for the homeless women menstruating in the streets. Today is for the low-wage women who can't take a day off from work. Today is for the women who don't eat because they don't have the money to eat. Today is for the women who need you to swipe them in to the MTA women. Today is for the women who clean your campuses who you refuse to see. Today is for the adjunct professors who your campuses and your colleges refuse to pay. Today is for the women who are talked over in meetings, the women who are arrested for petty crimes. This is for the women who are drowning in debt and who feel ashamed about it. This is for the single women. This is for the married women who still don't have enough help. This is for the sex worker women. These are the things we can do, and these are the things we must do, because menstruation is still a global issue, and periods and vaginas are not dirty words, and everyone on this planet. Because everyone on this planet at one point was a fertilized egg who attached themselves to the wall of a uterus, who fed off of, and who survived from the uterine lining for oxygen and nutrients and protection. So the next time someone turns their face up at the mention of your uterus, you remind them that they fed off of a uterus. They received oxygen from the uterus. And I want my niece Raina and my niece Haley and all the little girls to know they are worth saving, worth seeing, worth praising, worth loving, worth breathing. They are, and you are, and I am.
The women's rights movement started with Haudenosaunee women, and it makes me so proud to say that. We've been invisible for far too long, and we're going to be invisible no more. Raise up my Indigenous sisters today on this beautiful day, because we are resilient, we are brilliant, we are amazing, we are strong, We are beautiful, we are loving, we are compassionate, and we are fierce. You know, I think of all the things that the U.S. took from us when they came to our lands and what they did to our people. The one thing they didn't take was the power of women. You see, where I come from, women choose our leadership. We control that. We set them up and we can take them down. And I'll tell you right now, that bastard sitting in the White House wouldn't be sitting there today if you guys had that privilege as well. There are no limits to what we can accomplish when united. Today, I'd like to raise up some of my sisters that have passed away, some of them during the cause of fighting for our rights. Ingrid Washin-Watok Elisa. My beloved Aunt Tanya Ganella Fritschner, who started the American Indian Law Alliance. Berta Caceres, who lost her life defending her lands. Nobody should have to lose their life defending their lands and their water. Audrey Shenandoah, who was a clan mother of my nation, who fought tirelessly for the environment, an amazing woman, and another clan mother for my nation, Phoebe Hills, who without her, I don't know that our nation would have survived. She kept our longhouse going. But the woman that I admire most is Mother Earth. She's neglected, she's taken advantage of for her resources, and she's disrespected. And yet she still sends her love to us every single day. It's so important to be thankful. You know, when we start any kind of gathering, we always do an opening, a Thanksgiving, where we thank every single living being for everything that it provides us on this earth to live. And I think it would do us all good if everybody practiced that sense of thankfulness. I'm also asking you all to be thankful, mindful, but to also take action. Because what's happening today against Mother Earth is in direct reflection of what's happening in our society. As we see the pipelines going forward, right, this leads to more sexual violence against our women as these transient companies come in to our territories and abuse our women. United. This doesn't just affect me, it affects all of our seven generations yet unborn that are looking up to us from under the earth and watching every decision that we make. Our girls are watching us. We need to stand up for the rights of Mother Earth. The most effective and compelling movements were movements born from women. We are amazing. I want to say one last thing. Don't diminish your light because somebody else can't stand it. It's too damn bad. Be powerful and know you're loved. Thank you.
the president of the American Indian Law Alliance and an indigenous and environmental activist.
Women. We are amazing.
diminish your light because somebody else can't stand it. It's too damn bad. Be powerful and know your love. Thank you.
Repression
Palestinians export freedom and liberation. Protests as strikes to the Arab world came from Palestine. Popular resistance tactics shared with the Black Lives Matter movement, the BDS movement, reawakened the worker strike and reignited campus activism. Palestinian freedom fighters fought the Contras in Nicaragua, and in Palestine, they fight for each other, practicing the ultimate self-sacrifice and love of each other, community, and the land. The Palestinian resistance, my beautiful people, is beautiful, and it is deserving of its Soweto moment. It is deserving of its Algiers moment when they are joined by all of you in the streets to celebrate their victory in shaking off the yokes of Zionist colonialism, when they can dismantle the Zionist ruling class, which threatens every one of you, every woman, everywhere. And so because their victory is your victory, we ask that you join us in the sacred chant of Long Live Palestine!
Long live Palestine!
Professional Staff Congress, which is the union representing faculty and staff at the City University of New York system. Sharon from PSC is joining us now.